Restricted towards only 25 nautical miles radius from the airport or to and from the training. take my friends out for city flights, or I was building ours, or continued my PPL training as well. वहाँ पे PPL में it's basically to start flying.
Zulu Alpha India approach, copied, continue approach 36 left.
And check with one of the senior instructors. And if they clear you out, you fly solo navigations, which also includes 300 nautical miles, 2 full stops, and a refueling stop.
Alpha Alpha India, tower 1181.
I did 4 of my complete 300 nautical miles solo navigation, just where 2 full stops stay. One was up, towards the west, and one was southwest. And I did another up north. So it was a very good exposure, you're flying all alone in the cockpit. I didn't get lost as well. Or as much as your experience, I think you're the only one, you need to use your maps and find your way out, considering fuel and everything. So Pakistan, what I've seen is that you have solo navigations that you don't have. Of course, they have safety concerns and everything. But there, overseas flying, you do get a lot of exposure. So I guess that pretty much answers the questions of Shuja. But if you have any more questions, you're most welcome to ask.
Okay, one more thing that they keep on asking. Conversion ka kya process hai when you come back to Pakistan?
Conjugate whiskey, confirm attaining 80.
So we are passing 70, climbing 80, altitude cruising.
Conversion from Australian license to Pakistani license? My experience was...
Altitude whiskey 1275, Allah.
Controlies 1275, thank you sir, Allah is altitude cruising.
Control, Stomach, Alpha, Papa, Bravo, Juliet, Whiskey. Whiskey, confirm level passing.
So we are passing 70, climbing 80, squawk 2726, Alpha, Juliet, Whiskey.
Passing climb level 80, report to Moki.
80, call you back to Moki, Alpha, Juliet, Whiskey.
Okay, that's all. Coming back, conversion process was a bit okay. Technically, Pakistan does not accept exams in Australia, so I had to undergo the whole process of giving my PPL exams. Credits go to our director of operations, retired Air Commodore Sazia, jinki events help ke wajah se my 110 hours 36 minutes jo the wo unki wajah exception mil gayi thi. So I had to continue from 111th hour for Pakistan. So procedure mera wahi chala tha, I was issued a student pilot license. It was very hectic, I had to wait about 7 months to get my security clearances done, which to my knowledge is a very long time. Being a Pakistani citizen, Australia mein meri security clearances took maximum 20 days and it was all cleared. Pakistan mein, however, it took 7 months, very surprising. But of course, yahan ke bhi procedures, they are understandable. Got my student pilot license, gave all my PPL exams, gave a flight test, got issued my PPL license, continued my PPL training, and eventually I made my CPL and IR from Pakistan, got my license, and I've been flying as an instructor. So, the license conversion is a bit hectic.
And the last thing, Australia, what are the job opportunities for new pilots? For like if somebody wants to go from here to there,
job opportunities, I would say ke, kyunke these countries are very vast, so don't think of a job in an airliner until you hold your ADPLs. With your CPL, you can get a flight instructor rating and try your luck getting a job as a flight instructor. But airliners or flying for tall or charters do go for your ADPLs first. That will give you better chances for your flying jobs there. Pakistan, you can get inducted in PIA. Australia ki national airline is Qantas. Again, Qantas will give preference to Australian nationals. Aapko preference milegi if you have a lot of experience plus your ADPLs. So that's how you go about the jobs.
So thank you. Baki, we're continuing our flight to Sialkot. We're going to do a DMB arc. That inshallah also for another video. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video and inshallah more videos from the sky soon. Allah Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz.